Today's discussion is on mirror equation. Okay, now equation means which relates the physical quantities, we call it as equation. So now we have to make a relation to connect the variables, the parameters which are present in the mirror. It may be convex or it may be concave. We have to derive a general equation. See, in the last lecture we studied that the position of the image, that image distance, it depends on object distance, and that position depends on somewhat it is related to the focal length. That means if I derive the relation between the object distance, image distance and the focal length, now that single equation can be used to study the mirrors here. Okay, in the sense we can study the magnification, we can study the position. During the application part also, we can use that particular equation. So now that equation we call it as mirror equation. What is mirror equation? The equation which connect the object distance, image distance and focal length of the mirror. Now that equation is called mirror equation. We should connect object distance, image distance and focal length. Okay, so for the particular derivation, let us use some simple geometry and the sign convention to derive the relation between them. See, for the sake of discussion, let me take the concave mirror. Now this equation is applicable convex also, but for the particular derivation, let me assume that I have considered the concave mirror. Okay, now this is the concave mirror here. So you know that the position of the image depends on the position of the object. Let me take a typical case here. Okay, so this point is F, principal focus. Okay, so this particular point is C. See, let me take the case where the object is beyond C. Okay, let me take this particular case here when object is beyond C. Let me take AB as my object. Okay, AB is the object. Okay, so let me start draw the ray diagram. So you know that ray diagram. Okay, so you can have the ray diagram by using the three rays here. Okay, so you can have any infinite number of rays, but for the sake of derivation, for the simplicity, let us take the three rays here, one from the head and is parallel to the principal axis after reflection. You know that when light gets reflected, it passes through the principal focus. So this is your first ray. Okay, and the second ray, it starts from what? It starts from the, okay, you know that. The second ray, it starts from A, it passes through the center of curvature. Is it correct? It passes through the center of curvature. You know that if it passes through the center of curvature, so this is nothing but a radius normal, that is perpendicular to the surface. If I is equal to 0, then R is equal to 0, therefore this particular ray, it get reflected back and it intersect at this particular point here. Okay, this is the point of incidence. Let me take as M. So this is your pole P. Okay, you can see here third ray, it is taken from B and passes through the center of curvature and it is undeviated. That means these two rays intersect at this particular point here. If A is the starting point, then it get reflected and they are going to intersect at this particular point. So this is nothing but, this point is nothing but the image of A, and we call this point as A dash. Okay, similarly if I take large number of sets of parallel lines, then they are going to intersect at this particular points here. Okay, so if I take the a line which intersects each point, so this point becomes, it is the image of B, let me call it as B dash. Is it correct? Okay, so this is A dash, so this is your A dash, and this is your B dash. So what is A dash and B dash? A dash and B dash are nothing but image. So AB is called object. So what is meant by image? If the rays after reflection or refraction, okay, so they intersect at a point and it forms what we call it as image here. Therefore, A dash and B dash is the image, AB is the object. Okay, so what is meant by focal length? So this is nothing but focal length, the distance between the principal focus and the pole is called the focal length. So this is your quantity by the name called F. This is focal length. What is object distance? The distance between object and the pole. The Cartesian sign convention rule number one says that all distances are measured from the pole. So therefore this distance is nothing but, so the distance of the object from the principal focus is nothing but u. Okay, so this is u, this is f, this is u, and this one is image here. Okay, image is A dash and B dash. Again, the distance of the image from the pole is nothing but, it is called image distance, and image distance is represented by V. Okay, U stand for object distance, V stand for image distance, and F stand for focal length. Okay, and we have to derive the relation between object distance, image distance, and focal length. For that one, let me take the help of some simplest geometry here. Oh, okay, so to derive the relation between U, V, F, let me use some geometry. So let me go for some geometrical construction here. Now what is the construction? Let me assume that. Okay, so let me draw the M in a downward direction so that it intersect at some point on the principal axis. Let me call this point as N. Okay, you can see here this N and P are, they are very close. Okay, so almost they are, you see. Okay, so this is Fn, it can be also written as Fp. Okay, now see, so we have drawn some geometrical construction here. Okay, we have draw a line Mn which is perpendicular to the principal axis so that I can get some right angle triangle here. You can see here, now this is triangle Fmp, it forms certain triangle. Okay, so let me derive the relation between U, V and F by taking these triangles. So simply let us search for the similar triangles here. You can see here, if we look at this particular shape here, A dash, B dash and F. Okay, so A dash, B dash and F, and if you look at the triangle MPF, you can see that this A dash, B dash and F and MPF are similar triangles. Is it correct? You can see here, so this angle is 90 as well as this angle is 90. So these two are opposite angles, that means they are equal. So two angles are equal, that means definitely the third angle also becomes same. So this angle is same as that of the B dash, A dash, F is same as that of FMP. So if the angles are same, then their sides are equal or the ratio of the sides are equal. Now such kind of triangles we call it as the similar triangles. Okay, you can see that the triangle A dash, B dash, F and MPF are are similar. Now these are similar triangles. Okay, so these triangles are similar triangles. If the triangles are similar, then their sides are equal or the ratio of their sides are equal. So if I take the triangle A dash, B dash, and F, in this particular triangle, if I use this side A dash, B dash, okay, so by, if I take the one more side here, A dash, B dash, if I take the ratio B dash, F, then that should be equal to A dash, B dash. It should be equal to this side. It should be equal to the ratio of MP. Okay, first you can write MN, the triangle MN. Okay, so let me take the MNF. Okay, not MPF. I have taken the point N. MN by MN by NF. Or you can also write it as MP by what? MP by PF. Reason is, now you can see here, this FN is almost equal to FP. Okay, NF is almost equal to PF like this. So therefore, I can say that it is MP by PF. Okay, and what is MP? Again, you see here, if you look at the MP here, MN or MP, you can see here, now this, as this rays are parallel, so this particular distance is same as that of AP. So instead of MP, I can write AP also. Therefore, it can be written as AP by PF. Okay, overall I can say that if I make some just remodify the equation, A dash B dash divided by AB divided by AB is equal to, I can write it as B dash F by PF. Let me call it as some equation number one. Okay, so are you getting me? So it is very simple. Okay, you can see here, you have to look at the similar triangles here. You have to find the similar triangles here, A dash, B dash, and F, and M, N, F are similar triangles, and you are using the property that the ratio of the sides of the triangles are equal. Okay, so similarly, let me search for one more triangle here. Okay, so let me search for one more triangle here. The triangle A dash B dash P, A dash B dash P, this complete triangle. Okay, now see. Now see here. So if I take that one, okay, so if I make one more line here, then it will be easy. Okay, so because we have to include the triangle ABP. Okay, so let me draw one more line here. Again, let me start from the point A. Okay, it is incident on P. Okay, earlier I have not drawn this line because it makes certain confusion here. Okay, we can't for, okay, so the diagram will be somewhat complicated. So therefore, let me draw the one more line here. It falls on P. Okay, you can see here. So this angle is same as that of this angle. Therefore, this one passes through. So again, it passes through this point only. Are you getting me? Okay, so this angle is same as that of this angle because, so this is an angle, this is the incident ray, this is the reflected ray. So law of reflection says that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Therefore, the same ray, it gets reflected back, and this is going to intersect at point A dash. Okay, so the diagram remains same. Okay, so let me take this triangle now. If you take this triangle A dash, B dash, and P, I can clearly see here. So again, this is a right angle triangle. A dash, B dash, and P, and the triangle. Very simple. I have to connect the relation between U, V, and F. Okay. So therefore, as I know the derivation, I am taking those triangles which relate U, V, and F here. Now see, if this is A dash, B dash, and P, so I have to take the one more triangle which connect this UVF. If I take the one more triangle here, ABP, the triangle ABP. A, B, P. Okay. So now see here, this time I am taking the triangle A dash, B dash, and P, and A, B, P. So again, you can see here this angle, the angle A dash, B dash, P, and the angle A, P, P are what? They are 90 degree. Okay. And second one is the angle A, P, B, and the angle B dash, P, A are equal. Because this is angle of incidence, this is angle of reflection. According to law of reflection, angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. So this angle is also same. If the two angles are same, definitely the third angle of the triangle should also be same. That means what? This angle B dash A, okay, P, that should be equal to what? That should be equal to this particular angle, okay, B, P, A, B. Therefore, the triangles are similar. Okay, if the triangles are similar, then I can say that the ratio of B dash, the ratio of the sides are equal. So B dash A dash, okay, the B dash A dash, B dash A dash upon this side, B dash P, it should be equal to, it should be equal to, now which is the side corresponding to B dash A dash? Now this is B A, BA by, okay, divided by the, which is the side corresponding to B dash P. Now this is BP. Now this is nothing but BP. Okay, is it correct? Okay, so now again just rearrange the terms like this. So again, let me take either you can write B dash A dash or A dash B dash. Is it correct? So A dash B dash upon, if I take AB, AB instead of B dash A dash, I am writing A dash B because the size remains same. Either you can write B dash A dash or you can write A dash B dash because the magnitude of the sides remain same. Okay, so B dash A dash upon BA, that is nothing but A dash B dash upon AB, that should be equal to what? I can write it as B dash P upon BP. B dash P upon BP. So let me write some equation number 2. So we have taken the set of triangles here. Okay, so we have derived in such a way that you can see here the left hand side of both equations are same, so that I can relate the left hand side of the right hand side of the two equations as equal. Therefore, from equation 1 and 2, I can say that from 1 and 2, you can see here, from 1 and 2, I can write it as A dash B dash upon AB is equal to B dash F upon PF, and that is equal to B dash P upon BP. Therefore, I can say that B dash F upon PF, that should be equal to B dash P by PP. Okay, so if finally I am relating some sides here, B dash F upon PF is equal to B dash P upon BP. So what is our actual derivation? We have to relate the equation between U, V and F. What is U? U is nothing but BP. Somewhat it is there. And what is V? V is nothing but okay, B dash P, as it is there, and focal length is nothing but PF is there. Okay, so it is correct. So somewhere we are very near to the derivation. What about B dash and F? So it is no quantity. Okay, it is some distance here. Therefore, we have to remove this B dash F, and we have to write in terms of the known terms here. The known terms are B dash P is known terms, that is image distance, BP is the object distance, PF is the focal length. Therefore, I have to evaluate this B dash F into known terms here. So B dash F, so this B dash F can be written as, now see, B dash F, I am going to write B dash P minus FP. Okay, B dash P minus FP. Okay, why? So now you know that b dash f is unknown term, but if you, what is b dash f? B dash f can be written as b dash p, this distance, minus fp. If you make b dash p minus fp, definitely you will get b dash f here. So we are replacing b dash f by b dash p minus fp. The reason is because b dash p is known, that is nothing but your image distance, and fp is known, that is nothing but your focal length. Therefore, you are removing the unknown terms with the known terms. That's all. Okay. So therefore, this one divided by pf is equal to, can be written as b dash p upon bp. Is it correct? Okay. So now we have to substitute the value of b dash p, fp, pf like that. Okay. So what is meant by bp, bp, bp? So bp is the distance between, so this point to this point, that is nothing but the distance between object and the pole. The distance between the object and the pole is nothing but u, is nothing but the object distance. Similarly, b dash p, b dash p, b dash p is nothing but the distance between image and the pole, image and the pole. So therefore, b dash p is nothing but your term b. Similarly, pf or fp, whatever may be, okay, this fp or pf is your nothing but the distance between p to f is nothing but what? It is nothing but the focal length. Okay, but in case of ray optics, we have to use the sign convention. Okay, before the substitution of the usual terms, we have to follow the sign convention, that is Cartesian sign convention. There are various rules in Cartesian sign convention. Rule number one says that all distances are measured from the pole. Okay, so simply we have, see, in every term you have the word by the name called p. P is nothing but pole. So definitely during our derivation we have taken p as a reference point. Okay, so therefore the first condition is satisfied. The condition number two says that if the direction of incident light and the direction of measurement are in the same direction, then that particular measurement is taken as positive. Okay, that particular measurement is taken as positive. Otherwise, that particular measurement is taken as the negative. Is it correct? Okay, so it is fp only. Okay, so it is not pf, it is fp only. So see, so this is a rule here. Rule number two says that the direction of measurement and the direction of incident light are same, then that particular measurement is taken as positive, otherwise it is taken as negative. Let me use that property here. Bp, bp, that means you are moving from b to, okay, so you are moving from B to P. But what the rule says, all the distances are measured from the pole. Okay, all the distances are measured from the pole. So therefore, you are moving from P to B. Okay, all distances are measured from the pole. Therefore, the object is here. You are moving towards P to B. So this is your direction of measurement. And what is the direction of incident light? This is the direction of incident. So your light is moving from, your light is moving from left to right. Okay, and the rule number one says that all distance are measured from the pole. That means you should measure your distance from the pole. So you, this is your direction of measurement and this is the direction of incident light. You can see here the direction of measurement and the direction of incident light are opposite. Therefore, this u becomes minus q. Okay, is it correct? Okay, so I am following the sign convention. See, therefore it becomes minus u. Similarly, b dash p, again the rule number one says that all distances are measured from the pole. So this is your p, pole is the reference point. Therefore, you have to start your measurement from. So this is your direction of measurement. You are starting from P, you are going towards B. And what is the direction of incident light? Okay, not about the reflected. The rule says that you have to look at the direction of incident light. So this is your direction of incident light. So direction of incident light is moving from left to right, and you are moving from right to left. Again, the image distance is also negative. Are you getting me? Okay, so therefore the sign convention is very important. Okay, in case of ray optics, whenever you substitute the value of this physical quantities, you have to follow the sign convention. So now look at FP. Again, what is FP? FP is nothing but a focal length. Again, all distance are measured from the pole. Therefore, so this is your direction of measurement. You are moving from P to F, and this is the direction of incident light. So the direction of incident light and the direction of measurement are opposite. Again, you have to take this focal length as negative. Okay. Okay. So therefore, it is very simple. Just you have to follow the sign convention. You have to follow all those three rules here. So now let me substitute the value of this U, P and F. What is B dash P? B dash P is nothing but minus V minus what is FP? Again, FP is nothing but minus F. So this minus of minus, so I'm going to become plus here, divided by PF, okay, PF or FP, whatever may be, okay, so your PF, so again your PF is minus F is equal to, now this is equal to B dash P, this is minus V upon BP. BP is nothing but minus U. The minus U. Okay, so if I just rearrange that terms here, this is minus V only. So the minus of minus become plus F divided by, again this is minus F is equal to minus V by minus U. That is nothing but it becomes V by U. V by U. Is it correct? Okay, so now this is nothing but this is okay. So this is a mirror equation which connect U, V, and F. But I want some beautiful equations which can be easily remembered. Okay, so therefore just the remodify these equations in such a way that we can get a simplified, easier equation. So what we do is very simple. So take the U and V on the other side. If I take U on the other side, this becomes. So this becomes minus QV. So this becomes plus UF. On the other side, you can write it as minus VF. Okay. So minus UV plus UF and is equal to minus VF. If I make the quantities as positive, then see here, if I take UF, if I take VF on the other side, automatically this become positive. So UF and VF, if I take minus UV on the other side, this becomes plus UV. Okay. Now, so the last step. So what we do is throughout divided by UVF. Okay, let me make this equation throughout divided by UEF here. Then I got some beautiful simple equation. Throughout this equation is divided by UVF here. Then what happens? Now see here, UF divided by UEF. Okay, so UF divided by each term. See, you have to divide the each term by UVF. Is it correct? Okay, that means what? Dividing by UVF means what? You are dividing each term by UEF. Both are same. So UF divided by UVF. Then what happens? Your UF, F get cancelled. So you're left with 1 by V. You're left with 1 by V plus. Now here VF, 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 VF get cancelled. Therefore you're left with 1 by U is equal to Here UV, UV get cancelled. You're left with 1 by F. So this is the relation between UV and F. Okay, this is the relation between UV and F, and this relation is called mirror equation. Okay, by using these equations, we can thoroughly study the formation of images, the nature of the images, the calculation of the magnification, and we can use this equation in case of the construction and working of optical instrument. Okay, so now this is about the mirror equation. See, we have derived this particular equation for concave mirror. Now the same equation is applicable for convex mirror also. Okay, so this mirrors means, mirror equation means, it is both for concave as well as the convex. So this is very important equation. Okay, we have the lens equation as well as the mirror equation with a slight modification. So this relation 1 by V plus 1 by U plus 1 by 1 by U is equal to 1 by F is nothing but mirror equation. So next thing, so before going into the refraction, so what is the use of these lenses and mirrors? See, we have the large number of uses here. And the one of the finest use of this mirrors and lenses is for the magnification. For the magnification purpose, we are using this mirrors and lenses. Okay, so we can see microscopes. In microscopes, we are using the lenses here. In the telescope, we are using the lenses. In microscope, okay, so we can see the object. We can see the object which are not visible to the naked eye. By using the microscope, we can see the object. We can see the spots on the moon by using the telescope. So because the telescope magnified, enlarged the size here. Are you getting me? Sometimes the concave mirror are used in in cascade type of telescopes. We are using the concave mirrors for the enlargement. Now that particular quantity is called magnification. In the last lecture, you know that in some cases your images are diminished, in some cases your images are enlarged, in some cases the size remains same. Therefore, there is a relative size between object and the image, and that relative size between the object and the image is measured by one quantity by the name called magnification. Okay, in this case it is called linear magnification. It is only we are looking at the height of the image and height of the object. That is called linear magnification. One more magnification is there. Angular magnification is also there. So in today's lecture, so let me derive the equation for the linear magnification. Magnification. Okay, so magnification is nothing but it gives the magnitude of that quantity of the image. Okay, so see by knowing the magnification, we can have the size of the image as well as the size of the object. This quantity gives how much of the image is magnified. Okay, what is the size of the image here? When we know the size of the object, so how will you define magnification? It is very simple. Magnification is simply defined as height of the image to the height of the object. Now this is very simple. How will you define magnification? Magnification is defined as height of the image divided by height of the object. In this particular case, you can see here the height of the image is less than height of the object. In this particular case, your magnification is less than 1. Reason is the size, the height of the image is less than height of the object. Okay, in some cases it may be greater than 1 also. Therefore, this particular quantity, it gives the information of the relative size of image as well as the object. Okay, so therefore M is equal to HI by H naught. So, but we have to connect this magnification in terms of UV and F, or simply we can write in terms of U and V also, because this U and V are a measurable quantity. Okay, if focal length is known, if the object distance is known, then you can easily measure image distance like this. So these are practically these are measurable quantities. Therefore, by using U, V and F, we can also measure the magnification here. Okay, let me go for the small derivation for the magnification. Therefore, what is magnification? Magnification is nothing but your height of the image to the height of the object. Okay, in this particular case, I can write it as, what is height of the image? It is nothing but A dash B dash divided by what is height of the object. Height of the object is AB is equal to, okay, is equal to, now let me relate with U and V so that the equation becomes very simpler. A dash B dash, so again, now let me see, I have to connect with respect to V and U. It is very simple. For that one, let me take that, if I consider the triangle ABP, if I take the triangle ABP and the triangle A dash, B dash and P, as already discussed, this ABP and A dash, B dash, P are similar triangles. Okay, you can see here, this ABP and A dash, B dash and P are similar triangles. If the triangles are similar, then what happens? The ratio of the sides of the triangles are also same. Therefore, you can write like this. So, A dash, B dash, on the other side it is AB divided by, okay, now see here, A dash, B dash, the corresponding side is B dash P on one side, and on the other side you can write it as A dash B dash, that is equal to B dash P. On the other side you can write AB by BP. Okay, therefore you can write A dash B dash by AB. Therefore you can write A dash B dash by AB can be written as B dash P by BP. Is it correct? A very simple one. B dash P by PP. Therefore, you can write the magnification as m is equal to, what is m? HI by H naught, that is nothing but A dash B dash by AB, that can be written as B dash P by BP. B dash P by PP. Okay, what is B dash P? You can see here, the B dash P is nothing but image distance, and what is BP? BP is nothing but object distance. Therefore, we can relate HI and H naught with respect to the measurable quantities, that is object distance as well as the image distance. But the problem is, again, we have to follow the sign convention. Okay, it is not easy, but again, you have to take, okay, the sign convention here. So that can be written as what is A dash B dash? That is nothing but what? That is nothing but HI. It's nothing but HI. Rule number 3 of sign convention. Rule number 1 says that all distances are measured from the pole. Rule number 2 says that if the direction of measurement and the direction of incident light are same, then that particular measurement is taken as positive. If the direction of measurement and the direction of incident light are opposite, then that measured quantity is taken as negative. Rule number 3 says that if you are measuring in the upper direction, okay, you are measuring the distance in the upper direction with respect to the x-axis, then that distance is taken as positive. If you are measuring in the downward direction with respect to the x-axis, then that particular distance are taken as negative. Okay, in that case, now you can see here, your B dash P is an negative quantity. B dash P is an negative quantity. Reason is, so you are moving towards downward direction, you are moving here. Okay, you can see here, this B dash P is the distance which is in the downward direction of x-axis. Okay, now this is the x-axis. You can see here, this is the x-axis, this is the upward direction, and this is the downward direction. So you can see that you are moving in the downward direction. Therefore, your HI, that particular distance, is negative. Okay, now similarly, if you take AB, then you can see that the AB is in the upward direction with respect to the x-axis. Therefore, this is H naught, height of the object, and this is an positive quantity because it is moving in the upward direction. Is it correct? And similarly, if you look at here, B dash P is what? B dash P is V. but it's not v, it is minus v, because all distance are measured from the pole. So you are starting from P to B. So this is your direction of measurement, and this is the direction of incident light. You can see here the direction of incident light and direction of measurement are opposite, therefore your v is negative. Okay, and whatever BP, you can see here BP, this is BP, so this again all distance are measured from the pole, therefore according to sign convention this is your direction of measurement and this is the direction of light. You can see here the direction of measurement and the direction of light are opposite, therefore it is minus u. Okay, so therefore this is minus v, this is minus u, at equality vehicle it becomes v by u. The equation remain the same. Okay, so this is v by u, but what is m? M is nothing but what? M is nothing but hi by h naught. In this case it becomes minus hi by h naught, therefore what is meant by hi by h naught? You can write here hi by h naught is nothing but minus v by u. Are you getting me? Is it correct? Okay, your final equation says that. Now if you look at the final equation, minus hi by h naught is equal to v by u, that means what? Hi by h naught is equal to minus v by u. So now this is the formula for magnification. So what is the formula for magnification? Magnification is nothing but the ratio of image distance to the object distance with negative sign. Therefore, by using the mirror equation, by using the formula for magnification, we can give the complete picture of the formation of the images in case of mirrors here. Okay, so now this is about reflection in the optical instruments. Again, we are continuing this particular reflection here, reflection topic there. But in the next lecture, we are going to study about the next phenomena, that is called refraction. Okay, we are going to study the refraction through the lenses, through the prisms, and in the end we are combining the mirrors as well as the lenses to study the optical instrument. Okay, so thank you for your kind attention.